Okay, the SQL CLI, this is basically the SQL developer command line utility. Like for example, if you want to avoid some SQL formatting, right? So you do not want to, you know, you do not want to do the column formatting and mapping anything, right? So you always have the SQL CLI. So let me show you a SQL CLI method.
We need to download some file for this to run this.
Yes, that's right. Yes, it's downloadable. You need to go to Oracle website for SQL CL, and you just need to. I think this it's hardly 60 or 70 MB in size, so it's really lightweight. And then you have to go to the bin directory. There you have this .sql file, and then you have to pass your username, password, and then the kind of you know the service name. That's it. Like for, I mean. It comes with a lot of formatting features. Like for example, let's first check the version. What is the version? So it's Oracle SQL Developer command line SQL CL version 21.4 build is this. Okay. And the most interesting feature that I'm really fan of the SQL CLI is the repeat function. For example, if you want to set account and you want to set it a watch. Like, are you guys familiar with the watch utility on the operating system? Have you ever used the watch command?
It will repeat it after some time. No?
Absolutely, absolutely correct. So same, I mean, this is anonymous. So we have got a repeat option here. Repeat, and then repeat 5. So after every 5 seconds, it will provide you 5 iterations, 5 results. So right now it's running, you know, the second iteration out of 5, right? So for example, if there is any developer like which is or you want to observe the row count, if it's really growing or not. So what you can do, set the repeat option here in the SQL CLI, and then you can, you know, keep a check on if the rows are growing and if the number of rows are either going down or it's adding or not. So that's how you can do it. Okay. Any questions about this?
No, sir.
Okay. And for example, if you want to check the DDL of a table or of a view or of an index, you always have to go and use the DBMS underscore metadata, right? So it's really complicated. You have to do the formatting. You have to get your syntax ready. Everything is in place. Otherwise, it'll throw an error, right? So the best way, if you are connected to your database using SQL CLI method, then always there is a simple command DDL and then the name of the object. Okay, there you go. You've got a complete DDL of this big tab table, right? So this is the big tab. This is the owner. ID, weight, time, and other information about the table space and segment allocation and everything. Okay. And in fact, it also showed you the create index statement as well, which is there on the top of this table, right? So there is this index using ID column. So it has provided you details about that too. Okay.
We do not need to give the view or index or nothing. Metalized thing.
Nothing.
Whatever nothing. Associated with the tables, it will give the all the
absolutely. Reasons. Absolutely. Okay. That's right. And there is one more option, like information. For example, if you want to check details like the last analyzed date, number of rows, any comment if there are any, or if there is an in-memory option that is enabled. So you just need to pass the information and then the name of the table. There you go. So because this table is just now created, so no stats were gathered, right? And that is the reason why we are actually not seeing any rows here, because this table is just now I've created for this specific session, right? The moment you collect your statistics, you will start seeing the last analyze and rows. Otherwise, this table has got how many rows? 6, 8, 6, 6, 7. But because the stats are not collected, that's why it's showing rows as 0. And in fact, not 0, it's not visible. It's not coming. Same is the case with the sample size. So for example, sometimes, you know, developer intentionally added some comments on the top of the table, right? So if there are any comments mentioned, so you can start seeing those comments as well. These are the column and their data types, null and other comments of if there are indexes, they're about the uniqueness, their status, right? And the column details, okay? I think there is another one, info plus, big tab. It'll give you more details. Yeah, I mean, in fact, the moment you try info plus option, you start seeing low value and high value and number of distinct records and histogram. Basically, low value, high value, num distincts and histograms are all associated with histogram specific information. Okay. Low value means the starting point of a histogram, and high value is the peak value of the histogram, and NDV is the number of distinct values. So it basically provides you information about the data spread or data distribution. And what was the type of the histogram created, if it's a frequency or a hybrid or a frequency, right? And yeah, that's it. So the moment you pass info plus, it will provide you some histogram specific information as well. Any questions?
Information and the DDL is can be used only on table or any type of object like view, synonym, etc. as well.
The DDL, okay, I think there is this view as well. Just a second, huh?
Yeah, yes.
Oh, so yes, we've got one view as well. Let's see if it provides detail about the view or not. Yep. Works for view as well. So everything is possible.
For information also, no?
Yes. Again, because information is, if you're passing the name of the view, that's basically created on the top of this table, right? Big tab. So it will basically provide you information about the big tab table only. Because as far as views are concerned, those are nothing. Those are just a way how you actually window your data, right? That's it. They have no existence as such. So that is why. Okay, one more interesting feature that I just able to recall is the create table, right? For example, if you want to do a create table as select, you have to do the create table as select this and that. So that, you know, you do not to do that stuff now anymore. You just need to write CTAS and then name of the table, which is the parent table. For example, you want to create a new table using this, right? Big tab underscore new. That's it. So you've got it, right?
So it will create only the metadata?
Yep.
Not the data.
Okay, what else is... auto tracing option. Yeah, let's see. Set. Okay. So now, are you guys familiar with the auto trace utility?
Yes. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. So for example, let me check. Select all from.
I had one question.
Yeah.
For example, the particular query, CTAS, big tab and big tab underscore new, it will create only the DDL or it will create a table on the databases?
No. I mean, I didn't get your question actually.
What is the purpose of this particular means command? CTAS, big tab and big tab underscore.
Oh, okay. So it's basically just provide your generates the DDL for you. That's it. It will not create the table for you.
Okay.
For example, big tab underscore new. Let's check. The table overview does not exist because it only provide you the CTAS statement. That's it. Right. Now, if you go and set the auto. Okay, sorry. Let's wait for some time. Because at the end of this, it will provide you the execution plan and also the statistics. Yes, so here it is. And if you are familiar with the auto tracing facility, earlier it has got very limited number of options, very limited number of data that actually provides. But now with this auto trace on within the SQL CLI, so now you'll start getting some more in-depth information about it. Like this is the SQL ID. So till here, it was there with earlier auto tracing facility as well, right? But if you go and check the statistics section, lot of new options are here, right? Consistent get examination, consistent get from the cache, pin for the fast path, DB block changes. So there were few which were earlier available with the auto tracing facility, but I think 30, 40 more they have actually added into the auto trace facility if you are using against any of your SQL statement. And the options, 30, 40 options, which are really not there in the auto tracing. Okay, so if you want to dig in deep, want to really understand what all are the performance statistics while running this SQL, so now you can go and use the SQL CLI and generate the auto tracing report for your SQL. Okay, back. All right, so that's all about the SQL CLI. Nothing more needs to be explained. Yeah, I think one more thing that I've observed recently, I've noticed like there are a few scenario where you want to have the SQL ID before you go and execute the query, right? And for example, so for example, like, yeah, let me first go to the SQL CL. Okay.
Can we query whatever we used to query on SQL Plus? We can query on SQL CL, right?
Yes, everything is possible. It's exactly the same. It just, you know, you're getting more formatting options and new feature added to it. Otherwise, it's a complete replacement of SQL, SQL Plus.
Okay.
So for example, like there is this formatting option, set back only. right? Now with this formatting option, now if you go and do a select all from, you've got the SQL ID. So what it actually does is, like, the moment you set feedback only on SQL ID and you fire the SQL, it actually in real, it didn't execute it. It's only provided you the SQL ID. So if there is any use case where you want to get the SQL ID before the SQL gets executed on the system, so what you can do, if you're using SQL CLI, and then you can go and use the set feedback only SQL underscore ID. Just a simple, you know, thing that I was able to recall. Okay.
It will also work for the big query, no? Whatever we.
For the?
Big query.
Big query means a long query.
Yes. Yeah, the long query.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, definitely. Yes, it will work. Okay.
Mm-hmm.